Hello friends, welcome. Today's video is about let your light shine before you. And it's true, it really is, that as a spiritual being, we do shine light before us. And the more progressed you become, the better person you become, the more loving, kind, thoughtful, sensitive, merciful, compassionate, you know, the whole range of things that you become that are beneficial to be as a spiritual being, your light truly begins to shine before you. And my spirit wife, Su Ling's on plane 10, which is, you know, the highest plane that people have evolved to so far. And she come to me in a vision back in 1992. And it was as though I could see her light emanating from her spirit. It was not, I couldn't see it with my eyes. I could just see her, you know, as a person with my eyes. But it was almost like psychically I could perceive there was a great light shining forth before her. And, you know, that's true. It is true. And, you know, with some people down here, you think, you know, they've got such a good nature and such a loving heart and stuff. It is like they almost shine positivity. And, you know, it's very true that lots of people are very attracted to very nice, you know, positive people. They're just like a light that attracts those people to them. And when you're feeling down and despondent and miserable, you look like you're putting out, you know, a lesser light, or, you know, some more negative emanations are coming out of your spirit because you're not feeling well. And that's not your fault necessarily, is it? Of course not. But, you know, you find people are going the opposite direction, away from you rather than being attracted to you. So people that are very popular, you know, and nice people that are very popular, they do get a lot of people, you know, very attracted to them because they're attracted to that positive energy, to that light that's being emanated. And, you know, those that are very negative and miserable, you know, people don't go near them so often. So we're psychically picking that up from people here on this world. We're, you know, already psychically picking that up, and it's the law of attraction, you know, or unattraction, whichever it might be. So it's very true. And here and in the next realms above, you know, all the planes above this, this is plane one, this plane, humans have evolved to plane 10. Father God's on plane 12. We don't know what's on plane 11. But, you know, each plane, their light shines before them. And the truism is that nobody is judged unfit to go into the spirit realm. Everybody's allowed to. It's our eternal home. It's the next plane of evolution. So although it's no more evolved, it could be in some ways, and is in some ways, but in many ways, the people are just the same there as they are here, because you're not suddenly made into a very positive person just because you pass into spirit. You're the same as you were on the earth. So if you're a very positive person, you're going to be positive still there. If you're a very negative person and suffering, quite often it will continue there. So it doesn't set us free of all these burdens, because that's a personal task of evolution and overcoming suffering that is still there on the next plane. So we have to learn to cast out darkness, overcome and cast out suffering, and go beyond those things. And every step you take in that direction is a little bit more light shining before you, isn't it? Emanating out of your spirit, because you're becoming an ever stronger and more positive person. So some people on this plane are very, very spiritual in the right way and very good people. And occasionally a person from this plane, instead of going to the next plane of evolution, will actually go to plane 3. It's quite rare, because the majority of us here go to the next plane of evolution still. So yeah, it has happened though, that very progressed people, very, very spiritual people go to plane 3. And it was decided by Father God that the Native American Indians as a nation would be allowed to all go to plane 3 because of their spirituality. Very spiritual, many of the Native American Indians. So they achieved that. I don't know of any other, you know, nations that have ever achieved that. Maybe some have, maybe not. I don't know. So anyway, you know, you are judged not by God, not by any in the spirit realm, unless you've committed crimes down here. If you've committed minor crimes, you don't need to worry, because, you know, you probably learnt from them, hopefully. But if you've committed a major crime upon the earth, then it's the authorities in the spirit realm will know about that, and, you know, you'll be held accountable for it, of course. So in most countries you will. Because they know about all crimes we commit down here, don't they, Spirit? They're around us. So anyway, so no judgment of going into the spirit realm. So, you know, you are your own judge by the amount of light you're shining. And that's the truth, isn't it? It is your light that's emanating from your spirit that decides whether you're, you know, where you should be in the spirit realm. So most of us just go to the next plane because that's the amount of light we're shining. But there's other things besides that. If you want to evolve and go to plane three, then again, your light keeps progressing. When you get to a certain amount of light, you're free to pass to the next plane, plane three. Same with plane four. But it's not just light that you're shining, is it? It's all those attributes you're bringing into yourself that are good to be as a human being. Loving, caring, merciful, you know, compassionate, thoughtful, honest, you know, so many things that we can learn to better ourselves, that we bring onto ourselves that helps that light to grow. And so you are your own judge by the amount of light you shine. And on the next plane, there's people of quite a big, nice light, you know, not highly evolved, but a nice light. So you get the normal people, like most of us are, including myself. You get those that are fairly good people, very good people. You get those that are quite bad, fairly bad people, and very bad people, damn right evil, some of them, on the next plane of spirit. Now, there's no evil people hardly on plane three because they don't shine enough light to get there, do they? So that's a bit of a trap for them. If they don't want to progress and they want to stay being negative or evil, that they'll remain on plane two. So each plane gets ever more peaceful and ever more evolved. So you're pretty peaceful by the time you get to plane three and four. So after that, it's more about spiritual evolution and bettering yourself. So to progress yourself in spirit, it's about casting off negativity, casting off negative things that we become, and embracing light and becoming more positive. And it's the law of attraction. As you do that, people will be attracted to you. So that's the truth. So really, we're our own judges where we should be in the spirit realm. And, you know, by the amount of progression we are at, and evolution, and the amount of light we shine. So they all contribute towards evolution in the spirit realm. And, you know, the spirits say the continual evolution open to every human soul in the life hereafter, you know, in the spirit realm. And that's true. We all have the opportunity there and here, you know, because this is the start of our evolution to keep progressing ourselves. So each day is a lesson. You go out there and say, what can I learn from today's experiences about bettering myself or coming to an understanding, learning something new that can help me to keep progressing? So you start here. A lot of suffering on this world, quite a lot of suffering on the next plane too, because we're just the same. It's etheric physical plane. It's more or less like it is here. We have bodies, we rejuvenate. There's no physical illness. There's still mental illness in the spirit realm, because that's something that's taken on by us, not caused by any physical means. So if you had a mental illness down here that's some physical impairment or something physical causing it, you wouldn't have that in the spirit realm. But, you know, you get depressed down here because you were treated badly as a child and stay depressed all your life here and go into the spirit realm. You will still be depressed until you overcome that suffering. And that's the truth. So there is mental illness there because we still suffer, don't we? And, you know, that we've got to cast that off and try to keep going, getting to the top of the mountain to overcome those things. Anyway, that's the way it goes. You know, it's a natural process by the light we shine, by the amount we evolve ourselves to keep progressing eternally. And it pays off, because if you ask people that are on plane 10, was it worth it? And it is hard work and a struggle to keep progressing yourself and being positive, isn't it? It's easy to be negative, but not good for you. So to keep striving to be positive and overcoming the suffering and problems of life in a much more optimistic and positive state is going to benefit you as a person, and eternally benefit you as a person to keep doing that, because you progress. And the people on plane 10, if you ask them, was it worth the struggle to get here? They'll all tell you it was. So they're much happier there, much happier than they are on this plane or the next. So yeah, my advice to you is, you know, open your mind to eternal progression of yourself and your spirit and your soul. Love and light to you. Hope you enjoyed that. Neil.